What up, everybody? This is Stuart Knight, author of the books Marginalized and White Supremacy, Poetic Visions, A Sleep Mr. for a Sister, and A Spirit the World Has Forgotten. And today I want to talk about this little dust-up over Floyd Mayweather and the Gucci ad mimicking blackface with the scarf that was pulled up over the face, and Floyd Mayweather soon after going into the Gucci store and spending a boatload of money, you know, to kind of symbolize that, you know, don't matter what they do, you know, we should go ahead and still do ourselves. The one thing about that is that, you know, Floyd Mayweather's a fantastic boxer and everything. He's definitely earned his money. But one thing he should not do is, in times of, you know, white supremacy, white people practicing racism and white supremacy, is go out there and make a tomfool of himself. Because, you know, many of us don't understand that, you know, when white supremacists see an action that, you know, is done by one black person, they judge the whole collective by that. So to go out there, you know, and engage in some highfalutin cooning, you know, it makes us all, in a sense, look like fools. Now, you know, I don't really care what a white supremacist think, neither do most of us. But still, you know, it makes it harder for us as a multitude of people to try to get across to these white supremacists that no more, you know, we're not having their racist actions any longer and anymore. Plus, you know, I think what is really this, what this really all was about with Floyd Mayweather was a little bit of dick measuring. You know, him and T.I. had a dust up a while back behind T.I.'s lady. And I think when T.I. came out about, you know, boycott Gucci or whatever have you, Floyd's, you know, like some, you know, soft ass, you know, bitch niggas do when they didn't have sex with your woman. They want to go out and try to one up you, or, you know, flaunt on you, front on you in a sense, to try to make you look like less of a man. That's why I think, you know, Floyd Mayweather might have done that, you know, which is, you know, pretty sad, you know. But the bigger issue that we should look at behind this Gucci dust up is black people consistently and constantly responding to the inferences of racism, white supremacy that white people engage in, just to try to stir up our emotions. See, what most of us don't understand is that when they do such things and we respond, you know, in an angry or hurtful manner, they know that they still control us. Many of us don't understand that, you know, in making the slave, you know, the white supremacy inculcated into the mind and the emotions of that black person, their archetype of what they wanted a true white supremacist in dark skin to be. And sadly, many of us still carry on these traits and these behaviors amongst ourselves still today as a people. So the one thing that we can do to know that we are really progressing away from white supremacy is to not respond to these little notions or inferences that they engage in to try to stir us up. You know, like the great Neely Fuller has said, you know, if you are a black person living up under a system of white supremacy, expect to be mistreated. You know, once we get that within our heads, then we will not respond to these little actions that white supremacists engage in. Then, if we was to do that, then the white supremacists would know that they are in trouble, that the black people have finally begun to start thinking of themselves and forming their own sense of self, separate away from white supremacist thinking. That's where we need to get to as a people, you know, to cultivate within our collective our best and better selves for the complete and total empowerment of the people as a whole. So that way, you know, we can rid ourselves of some of these little silly actions, you know, that many of us engage in, like when, you know, black people are really chopping up some serious stuff online about, you know, nationhood and history. You know, you got a bunch of jokers that want to be in the chat always cracking jokes, talking about, you know, what people look like, you know, what potentially what people smell like, you know, just you know, as a response, you know, just to, you know, not really take in the hard subjects that are being talked about in the moment as to how we need to change our sense, change our being, you know, as people, you know, to move away from white supremacy. You know, all that, you know, all that silly nonsense that goes on, you know, when black people are really trying to chop up some serious stuff about superficial judgments, that needs to end. You know, that really needs to quit. You know, if you as a black person are not serious about trying to free yourself from the clutches of white supremacy, then stay away. You know, if you want to engage in tomfoolery, you know, and clowning, you know, start your own comedy show. You know, those black people who are over here trying to, you know, build and do things, you know, that's going to have a generational effect in our upliftment. You know, we don't need clowns, you know, interrupting, you know, just because they want a little bit of attention or they want to deflect away from the pains that they have to suffer from up under white supremacy. So just end the tomfoolery in all of its shapes, facets, and fashions. And once again, you know, don't respond to white supremacist aggression in that sense. Once they know that you're not responding and you're countering, you know, their actions, then they know that you are freeing yourself as a people, and then they see you as dangerous. And that's what you want. You want the white supremacy to see you as dangerous, not a threat. Because then they have to think. And when they have to think, that's when we got here. Once again, this is Stuart Knight, author of the books Marginalizing White Supremacy, Poetic Visions, A Sleep Mister for a Sister, and my latest work, A Spirit the World Has Forgotten. Peace.